topic is Bachelor of Computer Science in RMIT.
Talk about Canada. So, you know, everyone knows about the weather. I feel like it's disgusting weather. I felt like RMIT was value for money. Because the fees was all same, but why not go for, you know, a better quality.
Same, okay.
Before the scholarship, like if you're applying it just like a general student, so I think it is around like $40,000.
Yep.
Because I didn't have any prior experience, but coming here, when I did like, I did 1.5 year for programming, it's pretty difficult.
Hi guys, and welcome back to another vlog. This is KapsLock with Lakshya from RMIT Alumni Code. And we are back with another video. Something that you were really asking about and when we are going to shoot the video, which is, so the topic is Bachelor of Computer Science in RMIT. Because there's two courses, one is IT, Normal Information Technology, and this CS. So I guess after talking to Lakshya, we can have better idea what's CS and what's IT, and also you can have an idea of how to choose the course and how you can, you know, pursue the course, pursue Australia, pursue RMIT or any other university if you want to understand what the course is. And it will be really just honest answers, whatever you feel. It's okay if you feel good or feel bad, just be honest.
Yeah.
And we are going to start the video in just now. Tell me something about yourself first.
All right. So, hello everyone. My name is Lakshya Sistema and I'm currently studying in the second year of CS at RMIT. So, it's been a pretty, you know, like, a roller coaster ride for me.
Yeah,
because, you know, at first coming from India all by myself, starting and setting up the base.
Yep.
And then, you know, different culture, different study things, different pattern. So yeah, it's been a really, you know, I would say
up and down.
Yeah, but it's all managing.
It's all manageable. Overall, it's a good experience, or overall it's a bad experience?
I would say it's overall it's a really good experience. You know, you get to meet new people. You get to get, like, you get out of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
You're working, you're learning different things.
Yep.
You become like multitask. You'll be good in multitasking, right?
Yeah.
And it's good to, you know, just complete so many things in just one go and have the experience of properly being an international student and learning what you can do in just some semesters.
Yeah. Right? It's like just like 6 semesters. And, you know, it's in India, it's like, One sem is for like around like 6 months.
Yeah.
But here it's like 2.5 months.
So where do you belong from, India?
I belong from Chandigarh.
Okay.
Yeah, it's in Punjab.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now let's come to the main inquiries, the main questions of the course.
Yeah.
So first of all, before starting about the course, let's start about RMIT.
Right.
Why RMIT? Or before this, why Australia? First option.
Yeah, so we got like a different options when you like think about studying abroad, right?
Yeah.
So we start with US, Canada, and Australia. Like these are the three main countries, right? Like the top three priorities of an Indian student coming abroad.
Or any other student.
Yeah, any just be any student.
Yeah.
So yeah, so at first I would talk about Canada. So, you know, everyone knows about the weather. I feel like it's disgusting weather. Honestly.
I can't.
Yeah, even me, because, you know, it's snowing for like 7-8 months.
Yeah.
And don't quote me on that, but yeah, I think it's seven to eight months, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and I cannot bear that, honestly. So you have to work and you have to do everything. So yeah. I don't think it's a better place to be. And so, also, if you see a bachelor's degree in Canada, so if you go in like, if you're choosing around a 400 to like 450 ranked university, like according to the world rankings.
Yeah.
So your fees will be around like 60 to 80 lakhs in Indian rupees.
Yeah.
But if you compare it to Australia, it's really cheap.
Okay.
Yeah.
Irrespective of the university, or it depends on?
No. So if you talk about RMIT, it's RMIT is top 10 in Australia. And it's like, it's in 150 in the world.
Yeah.
But if you see in Canada, it's, if you see any university in like 450 or like 500, the fees is going to be much more higher than what RMIT is offering. Yeah.
Okay. So these were the main reasons why you chose Australia.
Yeah. Yes.
And coming to RMIT, why did you choose RMIT after you chose Australia?
Okay.
Why did you choose RMIT?
So I applied to like many different universities here, coming to like Swinburne, Deakin, RMIT. And yeah, these were the three main in Melbourne. For this course.
Okay.
So I would say Deakin, I researched about all the three of them. So I would say the topmost reason was Both Swinburne and RMIT is a tech university.
Uh-huh.
So while researching, according to like, while searching about both of them,
the courses,
so yeah. RMIT offers the CS course. It's I think it's the best course offered in all over Australia.
Boom.
For like computer science, because for their like Bootcamp Studio Model,
uh-huh.
it's really good.
So this Bootcamp Studio Model, only this university has?
Only this university offers, because it's like it allows you to have practical hands-on experience
uh-huh.
while you study. But if you go in Deakin, it's, you know, it's all theory-based. And, you know, and also one of the main reasons was, like, ranking was one of the topmost priority for me.
For this course?
The QS ranking, because it's like fees is almost like it's pretty much same for every uni.
Yeah, that I agree.
Yeah, yeah, I think, and also I applied for scholarships and stuff. Mm-hmm. So I got scholarships at all the three unis.
Yeah,
but I think I felt like RMIT was value for money, because
yeah.
the fees was all same.
Mm-hmm.
But why not go for, you know, a better
ranking, quality,
better quality?
Same, same.
Yeah,
okay. So you kind of compared and put down all the notes.
Yeah.
And you did a proper research on that, and then you chose
yeah.
RMIT.
So it was like also one of the main reasons is the location of this campus.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone knows like city is the hub, right?
Yeah.
So we got all different opportunities. We got all the like the main office buildings
uh-huh.
in campus.
Mm-hmm.
So like in and around the campus,
yeah.
right? Yeah. So I felt like it's really a
good choice
place.
For you.
Yeah.
Now, so this was the Australian RMIT. Let's come to the course now. Bachelor of Computer
yes.
Science.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the first question, as you're talking about fees, let's start with fees. So what's the affordability? What's the fee structure
okay.
of this course?
So before the scholarship, like if you're applying it just like a general student,
uh-huh.
so it is around like $40,000.
Yep.
So
for the whole course?
No, it's like for 1 year.
$40,000 per year?
Per year. So it's a three-year degree.
So it means 40.
It comes to 120 a year.
Yep.
Yeah. So I don't know. That comes to 20 lakhs Indian rupees, right? For per year,
but I mean you can convert, because I guess the fees is always changing per year, right?
Yeah, it is. So I think now it's around 39,000 something. So that we can round it up to like $40,000.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah. So after I got the scholarship, it came down to $30,000
mm-hmm.
annually. So I'm paying like 90,000 for the whole degree.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's pretty much the fees.
Okay. And so how much scholarship did you get? 20%.
Yeah, the maximum.
Yeah, mostly 20%. The international students get 20% according to their stuff, but I mean sometimes the things have changed. Like if you did something which is creditable in your bachelor's, then if you're doing master's, then they just credit the point and then you don't need to pay for that particular course. So did we talk about this on some other video? Currently he's paying the fees with 20% scholarship.
Yeah.
And yeah, more information will be obviously on the website of the course that you're gonna pursue
yeah.
for. The next question is how the lecturers or the professors are in this course.
Okay. I'll be really honest with
yeah,
you.
Yeah, sure.
So I didn't. So for the first sem,
mm-hmm.
I attended every class. So
yep.
my first sem was a programming bootcamp model.
Uh huh.
So I did attend every class. So it was like four lectures in a week. So I attended everything, and I felt like, you know, you just go to the class, mm-hmm. and professor asks you to do the exact same thing that's
mm-hmm.
available online.
Yep.
That you can do at your home.
Okay.
So I felt like, you know, we are working, and at that time I didn't, you know, I was settling down.
Mm-hmm.
It was a new country. I had to find my home.
Mm-hmm.
I had to, you know, start with
yep.
eating and stuff, and
yep.
all the laundry and shit.
Yep.
So yeah, I felt I did manage like coming to all the four classes, but I didn't feel like it was, you know, worth it, because
uh-huh.
we did the exact same thing that we could do at our home as well.
Okay.
So they just asked us to, you know, continue with the lab exercises or just the online modules,
mm-hmm.
and we could have done that at our home as well, right?
Yep.
Why would we come to like traveling 40 minutes every day?
And yep.
But why would we?
After the semester, the next semester, then what the change happened?
Because we have like the Bootcamp Studio Model for the first year.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's pretty much the same thing happening
the second semester as well.
Every time, yeah. And right now we have like theory subjects coming on,
mm-hmm.
but I'm feeling like it's still the same thing,
because okay.
they just read out the, you know, the PDFs or the assignments that are available,
and then they ask you to make it.
Yeah, they just ask us to, you know, we can read it out. They just read it out with a lot of examples.
Okay.
So basically in India, it's like, in India, I think we have like lectures and stuff,
mm-hmm.
but here we have like workshops.
Yep.
It's really different.
Yep.
So we just, in workshops, we discuss about things rather
yep.
than they teaching us about
yep.
anything.
Yep. That I
yeah. So it's really a different thing. And
yep.
according to me, I didn't feel like it's worth for me to coming to uni. But yeah, when I have like doubts, because I study continuously at home, like for the online modules and stuff. And when I have any doubt or I don't understand the thing, so I just personally go to the professor in the lectures or in workshop and I just ask them.
And behavioral wise, I mean, the lectures and professors, do they reply on time or do they get back to you if you have any questions?
I would say,
in that case, are they good?
Yeah, they're pretty good with that. You just email them because they've got like a few different resources. Mm-hmm. We have, for each course, we have like a course coordinator, and then coming to all the courses, we have a course coordinator, and then we have like different mentors for like all the courses, like at least 5 to 6
assistant mentors
and professors
for each course.
Course
means subject matter,
yeah,
and the whole course means program.
Yeah,
so
we got mentors and stuff. So you can always reach out to mentors and the lectures, like the lecture professors.
Mm-hmm.
So they're gonna answer you offline as well as online. Okay. And every time you can just, you know, give them a text on Teams or just give them an email on Outlook, they're gonna reply back like maybe in 1 or 2 business days. Yeah.
So the next question is, so this is the question which is mostly answered by students in a broader perspective, but I guess some of the part you already said about the theoretical and practical part, but if you want to add about what's the course structure of this course?
Okay, so I would say, as I told you, like the first year we have, it's called the Programming Bootcamp Studio Model.
Yep.
So we have the bootcamp for, which goes for like around 6 to 8 weeks. And then we have the studio, which goes for like 12 weeks. So when you do this, so bootcamp is you learn about one programming language. So we did Java in the first one and C++ in the second one.
Mm-hmm.
And then we do like application based according to that, you know, related to that programming language, as well as more, like I would say more bits of, you know, programming and tech stuff. Yeah. And we, in the studio model, we apply them on, you know, some project, or we apply them on the real life. Because we made our own data-driven website in the first studio, and we did, like, it's a really famous game. I'm sure all must have known about it. It's called Minecraft, right?
Yep.
Yeah, so we developed and did projects using Minecraft.
Okay.
Yeah, in the second one. So coming to second year, we have, so mine is CS. I'm doing CS right now. So we have like all different, you know, components of CS, like cybersecurity, software engineering, and algorithms and analysis, data-driven analysis, all that stuff in the first sem. Sure. And then second sem, we can choose the major out of all those 5 to 6 subjects.
So first you just observe and check which one.
Yeah, so it's just like in first sem of second year, they just give us, you know, like a brief and just like a basic knowledge.
And then you just filter which one you're going to go for.
Yeah, so we have to choose either one major or 2 minors along with one elective course.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay. The next question is, what's the future pathways after doing this course? What are the future roles that come out after that?
So that totally depends on what major I'm going to choose.
Yeah.
So I would say if I'm going to, like, it's going to be better if I go in the same line. Like the whatever major I choose, it's going to be better if I go in that same field.
It'll be good.
Otherwise, I chose CS over all the, you know, you told about IT and
IT
stuff.
And all stuff
So that where all the, you know, all the different tech courses come on.
Makes sense.
So yeah. So if you're doing, so CS is like a broader perspective. You can go in any field you want.
Yep.
So you can do cybersecurity, you can do AI, machine learning, cloud computing, right? You can do programming, you can do web development, you can do anything if you're studying CS. So basically CS gives you knowledge of every, you know, every
unit. So this is the base, and then you need to check which one you go with.
So we can just, you know, we can work in that field, and, you know, we can see whatever field we are liking, and also we have to see the job scope as well. So if we like that job scope, and, you know, if we like whatever we are doing, so we can pursue a master's in that particular field.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then you can just go in whatever job role you want to go in.
Yeah, pretty much. Yes.
The next question is, and be honest with that.
Yeah.
Whatever you know, or you probably heard, or whatever you know about, what's the future PR pathways after doing this course?
Okay.
Industry.
That comes to a more serious point. So that's what I've heard.
Yeah.
Don't quote me on that, please.
Okay.
So that's what I've heard, that PR in CS, it's really difficult.
Okay.
I think you have to have like 90 points, 90 to 95 points. But even if you're having, so I think the basic is at least like 80 points, right? So even if some people are having 90 to 95 points, it takes around like 3 years to 4 years to, you know, get a PR invite. So I feel like if you're being above the minimum, it should be, you know, it should be pretty quick. Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, that's what I've heard. And I think it's better if you do software engineering according to the PR perspective.
Makes sense.
Yeah, because all the different engineers, they have a, you know, better
options. They have better options for getting PR in Australia.
Better options, yeah. But I would say if you're not sure what you want to do and which line you want to go, because if you choose software, you just have to be in the programming side.
Oh.
Yeah. So in India, after 12th, we don't know, like, you know what to do.
Yep. And then you suddenly jump into
software. Yeah, we just suddenly jump into software and, you know, students feel like, you know, programming is pretty hard and I don't want to pursue it as my career.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's, yeah, even me, because I used to thought, you know, programming would be great because I didn't have any prior experience. But coming here, when I did, like, I did 1.5 year for programming, it's pretty difficult.
Okay.
Yeah, so I felt like this programming is not for me. And I feel like cybersecurity and cloud computing and AI, it's those are the three components that are made for me. So I would pursue career in that.
Okay. Yeah, and that will be easy for you to get PR in Australia.
I wouldn't say it easy, but
pretty easier than this.
No, it's like you have to hustle.
Obviously.
Yeah, you cannot just, you know. There's no quick way.
There will be invite coming from the immigration department.
I would say obviously software has a better chance of getting, you know, giving you a PR, but yeah, you'll have to hustle. It's just all luck.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. So the last question, it's not a question, it's just basic stuff. What's your personal experience? We can briefly, because the video's already been so long.
Okay.
I don't want you guys to just get bored. By the way, he's giving good information to you, but still.
Yeah.
So briefly, what's your experience about Australia, RMIT, of course, whatever you want to say about
that? I would say that's what I said in the start. It's been a pretty roller coaster ride, and I've been, you know, I've made pretty new friends and, you know, new experiences.
Yep.
I've been working in codes, so yeah, it's really been a good journey. And you know, you do a lot of tasks at the same time. You're studying, you're earning money, you're partying with your friends, everything.
Yeah.
So you can travel, you can go international, it's everything.
Yeah.
So I would say it's been a pretty good journey till now, and I hope it will be good.
Okay. So let's share.
Yeah.
In RMIT, Capslog in RMIT. This was the video. And I'm mentioning Lakshya's Instagram here. If you want to have any questions answered, just text me up. Please reply to them whenever you get time. And also, if you get any time, you can just come back with the same video and check the YouTube comments and reply whenever you get time.
Definitely.
And my Instagram is also in the description. If you have any questions, if you want video on any other topic, let us know. And I hope this video will help people.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming, Lakshya. No, Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
And yep, so like, share, and subscribe. See you guys.
See you.
We'll meet in next video soon.
See you guys. Bye.